structure of ovule. Or megasporangium. So generally in the cycus, okay, ovule having or megasporangium having nutritive tissue. So this nutritive tissue is known as a nucellus. So inside the nucellus, one cell is developed into that megaspore mother cell. Megaspore mother cell. In that megaspore mother cell undergoes meiotic division by meiosis to producing four haploid spores. So they are known as that, okay. So it means four megaspores are formed. In these four megaspores, three are degenerate. Degenerate means destroy. Only remaining one is functional. One is functional. This functional megaspore, this functional megaspore by free nuclear division to produce female gametophyte. It has food material. It has food material so that it is considered as endosperm. So generally in gymnosperms, endosperm is formed, okay, before fertilization. That's why this endosperm is always in that haploid condition. Okay, so that is that, okay, some points about that ovule or megasporangium or female gametophyte, right? After that, the structure of ovule, so generally in gymnosperms, largest ovules in the plant kingdom. Generally they are that egg size. Example in cycas, okay, largest eggs, ovules, and largest female, largest male gametes. Okay, so these are that important. So in this one, it is known as that microphyll. Generally Ovules are orthotropous ovule. So that is known as microphylle. After that microphylle, it is known as the integument. Okay, so this is known as that pollen chamber. It is a new cellular beak. So this is known as that pollen chamber. After that, it is a endosperm. Are female gametophyte. So these are the archegonia. Right? When that, so pollen grains are, it means, so spread through, it means pollen grains are, okay, so it means spread by that wind and reach to that, okay, it means female reproductive organ, that is known as a microsporangium. So first one, this pollen grains are falls on that, okay, pollen chamber. So this pollen chamber is formed by the new cellular beak. Okay, so in microphylle to form a beak like structure in the new cells. So that is known as new cellular beak. In that, some new cellular beaks are converted into that, okay, cavity like structure. So that is known as a pollen chamber. So this pollen chamber, okay, having that pollen grains, it is present in that megasporangium of cycas ovule. It is a NEET 2017 question, important objective bit, pollen chamber, right? So after that, so that is known as that endosperm. So inside that endosperm, okay, 2 to 4 pair of archegonias are present. So this archegonia having that neck and venter, so inside the only single egg cell is present. When that pollen grains falls on that pollen chamber, it producing of that pollen tube. It producing of that pollen tube. Okay, so it germinated the pollen tube. This pollen tube carrying of male gamete. So these are the male gamete. When that pollen tube, it means, so that is known as the pollination. So after pollination, this pollen tube reach up to that, okay? So it is that archegonia. It is that archegonia. It is known as that neck. So it is that egg cell. When that pollen tube reach up to that, okay? So mouth of archegonia. Okay, then male gametes are released and fused with egg cell, okay, to form that zygote. After that zygote is converted into that embryo. So endosperm provide, okay, nourishment to the development of that embryo, okay. So that is that structure of that ovule and reproduction in gymnosperm plants. Generally, in all gymnosperm plants, what is that important point? In all gymnosperms plants, so generally zygogamous type of oogamy in all bryophyte and pteridophyte and gymnosperms. So all bryophytes and pteridophytes, generally it is a zygogamous type. All bryophytes and pteridophytes, so zygogamous type of oogamy. Type of oogamy. Okay, it means male gametes are motile and small. Female gamete is large and stationary. So if between that male and egg cell, both it is that undergoes fission, so that is known as that, okay, zygogamous type of oogamy. But in all gymnosperms and angiosperms, male gametes are carried by pollen tube. So that is known as siphonogamous. Okay. But in the cycas, what is the important point? In cycas, okay, half of that zygogamous and after that siphonogamous, both are present. Siphonogamous, zygogamous is both present. It means male gametes are motile. So generally they are that top shaped male gametes and multiceliate. Okay, is objective bit multiceliate, but and also carried by pollen tube. That is known as, so cycas showing of the zygogamous and siphonogamous both. Okay, that is the important point.